Y'all give it up for Tyler Cantu.
Keep it going for your girls. Actually, keep it going for this girl right here. You're the MVP of the night. I'm telling everybody to shut the fuck up. Keep it going for her, everybody. Thank you for channeling your inner Karen for all of us. You know, we really appreciate it. 99 out of 100 times I hate you, but tonight you're fucking okay. We appreciate it, you know? I really needed it too, because like, I don't get out much anymore because I'm a single dad, but there you go. But more importantly, as a dad, more importantly for me, I'm one of the few dads in this country that did get custody of his child after a breakup, and I'm very proud of that fact. Yeah, usually gets class, not single moms in the audience, that's why you can clap it up, thank you. Yeah, I killed her mom, so it was pretty easy, you know, but yeah, exactly, she did. No, but I have a new partner now. She came with a son, and I don't know if you guys know this, but it is scientifically proven that raising a son is about 6,000 times harder than raising a daughter. Like, it's true that, man. My son got in trouble at school the other day. I went and picked him up, and the teacher goes, Sawyer threatened some second graders today. He's in third grade. And I was like, oh, shit. What did he say? And she goes, well, he told this group that he was gonna kick them in the nuts and then suck their little penises. I was like, ma'am, I will talk to him, that's not okay. But also, not a threat, if we're being honest, you know what I mean? That's a job, actually. It's called a dominatrix, ma'am. Maybe my son was just trying to build a clientele basis. And you're diminishing his entrepreneurial spirit, and I don't appreciate it, you know? But we have a new partner, so does my ex. My daughter loves them both very much, but like any child, she kind of wants to see her mom and dad still together, right? That makes sense. That's why she told us she wished all four of us could just live together. Which I've explained to her is polyamory. Yeah, and in this form, it's called a quad, actually. And in this quad, mommy's new man is 6'2", 250. Yeah, so daddy's a bottom. Daddy's not daddy, you know? I love you, baby girl, but I gotta draw the line somewhere. And I feel like being the non-bear in a four-way is a fair place to draw that line, you know? Like, that being said, we do have a recession coming, right, guys? And I might be willing to tuck it back for a few extra grand a month for another income. You know what I mean? Like, me and baby girl can both get a new daddy if we have to. We will do what we gotta do to survive this economy, you know? But they both just got back from Palm Springs. That's where I'm originally from. Clap your hands if you guys over Palm Springs now, so I get a little feel of that here. Okay, yeah, makes sense. You look like you've had a bad acid trip at Coachella recently, so I totally get that for sure. Nah, it's a dope place to grow up. I mean, you're chilling out with half a stagecoach, so what are we talking about? You know what I mean? Like, yeah, there you go. But it's a dope place to grow up. We got the festivals, a lot of old people, you know? But the number one thing it's known for, and a lot of people, especially up here, are surprised to find this out, but it is the pride capital of California. Yeah, I know. A lot of people are like, what? San Francisco. Fuck San Francisco. Yeah, they don't have shit on my hometown. They just have shit on their streets now, from what I hear. That's what they're known for, you know? Exactly. And the thing is I'm a confident dude, and I attribute a lot of my confidence to growing up in the Pride community. Because I know there's a few guys here that probably won't want to admit this tonight, but if you need an ego boost, there is nothing better than getting hit on by a gay guy. They're the fucking best! Ladies, you should be taking notes when these guys get going. Because first of all, they're direct. Which, let's be honest, ladies, this is not your strong suit. You guys are about as direct as a Spirit Airlines flight. Let's be real. Yeah, second of all, they'll give you way better compliments. Like, my girl calls me handsome all the time, which is nice. But the best compliment I ever got was from a gay guy telling me I look like Keanu Reeves. Dipping gravy. I don't even know what that shit means, but it makes me feel really good. You know what I mean? Like, but the best thing is, these guys will offer you some of the wildest shit anytime, anywhere. I had a gay guy try to give me head at a coffee shop once in Palm Springs. Yeah, it was the barista too. Yeah, he was gonna work my tip to earn his, you know what I mean? But I ordered my coffee, like any other order. But after that, he looks at me and he goes, "Okay, sir, by the way, do you need the restroom code with that?" I was like, "I don't. That's a weird fucking question to ask it after ordering coffee." So I ignored it, handed him my money. But then as he handed me my change, he goes, rubs my hand, and says, "Are you sure you don't need the bathroom code with that, sir?" Yeah, I was like, "I still don't." So I'm kind of interested in what you're asking now, you know? So I ignored it though. I went and sat down, and then he calls me back up, gives me the coffee, slides me the coffee, and then slides me the receipt, and looks at me and goes, "By the way, sir, I wrote the restroom code on the receipt for you." Gives me a wink and says, "Just in case." Yeah. Now I gotta know what the fuck is in that restroom, you know what I mean? Like, curiosity now. So she said, "Nope, it's not for you, it's for me." So I did. I walked up to the restroom, knocked in the code, walked in. You guys know what I found in there? My new favorite coffee shop. That's what I fucking found. That's a 5-star Yelp review every time, you guys. $7.50 for a frappe and a BJ, you're not gonna beat that deal anywhere. Starbucks doesn't offer that shit, you know? No, I like making dirty jokes like this, guys. I'm glad you guys know. You're a cool fucking crowd, man. I like this, you know? But the thing is, you guys know, once you make enough of these kind of dirty jokes, especially around your friends, you start to learn some things about your friends, right? Like, I know for sure that there are really only two types of guys in this world now. There are guys that'll never let a girl play with their butthole in bed, and guys that love that shit, you know? And I always love the guys that get uncomfortably quiet during that joke because you know they're just trying to hide which one they are. Don't move, you won't be able to tell which one I am. And the guys that do talk about it, they'll talk about it so nonchalant, you know? They'll be like, "Dude, it's not a big deal. It's just a finger or two or three in your butt. It's not a big deal, dude." You're like, "Three? Jesus Christ, man, what are you doing in there, you know?" To me, it sounds kind of like heroin, you know? Because once you try it once, you just keep doing it over and over and over again. Already kicked the habit. Like, that's why I don't want to do it, because I don't want to be a bust-up junkie. You know, what does that mean? Like, now I'm going to spend all my money on Preparation H and lube? Be fashioning things to the inside of my jeans so I can get a little hit throughout the day? No! It's not what I want, you know? The thing is, too, we all know people that battle with addiction, right? And sometimes when you're addicted to something, you got an intervention to get off of it. Yeah, I don't want to have a bust-up intervention, guys. That sounds terrible, you know? Because now think about it. You guys a couple over here? Karen, you guys a couple? Well, yes, you are. Okay, you're complaining. Come on, you Karen. It's okay. It's a good Karen. You're a good Karen tonight. You guys a couple? Yes? All right. Imagine now you got a your family and friends over to this intervention, and you gotta explain why you constantly have pink eye. He's gotta explain why everything in the house shaped like a penis smells like shit. It's just not the conversation you wanna have, you know what I mean? And the thing is, too, like, even if I were to have that intervention right now, it wouldn't stick for us. I'm only 34. I've never had a prostate exam. Right? You're going to tell me the minute that doctor's finger goes in there, boop, relapse. Not even a point to do it. You know what I mean? Like I said, dirty jokes to your friends is fun. I lived with a group of guys in college, which was great. We had to go shopping together, which was fine and all. Still, you have to buy condoms together. Yeah, and then it's no fun when only one guy gets to buy the magnums, you know? And if you guys can tell, it's not me. I'm not up here to brag. I'm a 5'9 white guy doing silly dance moves on stage to make you guys laugh. Nothing about me screams big dick energy. I get that, you know? No, it was a black guy I lived with, actually. You know, obviously, you can guess. I lived in SoCal. I lived in a house under a bridge in a shitty town. Yeah, if you didn't live with a black guy, you were dead within the first 48 hours. That is the rule of thumb, you know? And here's the fucked up part, is when we would go shopping for condoms, my buddy would make it sound like having a big dick was a handicap. Yeah, he would be like, dude, you don't get it, dude. I have to buy these because if the girl only has the regular condoms on here, they don't roll all the way down to the base. Well, I'm sorry that our condoms fit your dick like a yarmulke. Fuck you and your big dick problems, your BDPs. Oh, dude, sometimes they won't even let me stick it all the way in because they tell me it hurts so bad. Okay, better than her asking you politely to put in more when that's all you have. I'd rather be on your end, big guy. It's not fun, you know? It's not fun. It's okay. You're like the final boss, Karen, for sure. Oh, thank you so much, man. Well, now that I've taught you guys I have a small dick, apparently, let's teach you guys something else, too, all right? I like to teach my audience. For men, did you guys know that your lips are the same colors as the tips of your dicks? Yeah, and women, you're not out of this either. Women, did you know that your bottom lip is the same color as your nipples?
That's a lie.
If you don't believe us, prove us wrong right now. We can make this a party. Send the results to Dr. Fauci in science. He'll listen to it. You know what I mean? Alright, guys. This is fun. I'm going to do one more. Guys, take a drink with me while I get ready for this. This is going to be a fun story. You guys enjoy this. You guys have a good time tonight. Take a drink with me. Right, fuck it. Let me set my drink right here. Okay, guys? Thank you very much. The drink table right here. We appreciate it. Thank you. Take care of us tonight. So, this is the story about watching my high school quarterback accidentally finish my best friend. Yeah, it always gets quiet because people are like, how the fuck does that happen on accident? It kind of doesn't. Let me explain, you know? See, what happened was one of my friends one day walked in, was playing video games, and my friend goes, hey man, I know this is going to sound crazy, but I've always wanted to masturbate while watching porn on your big screen. And I was like, man, you gotta get better dreams, my guy. I'm like, it's a low bar to clear, you know? But I'm not going to stand in the way of my friend and his dreams. So I handed him some Kleenex and tissue and sent him to the living room, you know? Yeah, and my quarterback comes in with another one of my friends a few minutes later. They go, hey man, where's Kelly? I go, he's in the living room right now watching one of our favorite shows. We're gonna let him do it solo, you know? They're like, no way, I tell him what's going on, they're like, we're gonna fuck with this guy, obviously, you know, we're teenagers. So we go out to the living room, or to my kitchen, because we can see in my living room from there. There's a couch blocking him, so we can't see the part that we don't want to see. We can't see his head, and it's shaking like one of those hula dancers on the dash of a car, you know? Yeah, just... So every guy here knows that means he's almost done, right? Like, we've all been there, you know? I mean, I jacked off, yeah. That's, every guy in here has. If your parent tells you he doesn't, he's lying. Then my quarterback gets this devious look on his face and goes, shh. We're like, where the fuck is this guy going right now? And he goes around the wall so my friend can't see him and jumps up and goes, ah, what? Slaps my friend in the dick. And he came. Yeah. And me and my other friend wondered, what the fuck we just saw happen right now? Like, and to this day, my quarterback, we're still friends, he'll try to defend himself. He'll say that he thought my friend was mashing the button on my controller for a video game. I'm like, dude, there's a naked girl on screen right now. What video games are you playing at home without us? So, you guys decided you think that was an accident or not. I will leave you with one more piece of information before I go. My quarterback never went on to do anything with football as good as he was. He did, however, open up a dope coffee shop in Palm Springs. And I love going to you guys. Thank you guys for the love tonight. You've been a fantastic crowd, man. Give it up, give it real loud for your host, Ian Nielsen, and y'all coming back to the stage.
Tyler Cantor, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, man.